Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to do a late Pretty Pan update for the Pan in Everything, also called Pie. I'm doing this with a few ladies here on YouTube and Instagram, and we started this in October and we are just going to keep going until we have pan on everything on our collection that we can hit pan on. So far I have hit pan on 7 products in this project since then, and for this update I have 2 more, so that is 9, and that is pretty exciting. So let's just go through the 2 pans that I have for this update, and we are working on 4 items in total at all times, at least I am. You can always join this project if you just let us know down in the comments. I will have a link to a playlist and everything so you can look more into it that way. You hit pan on a product and then you roll something else in. So you keep the momentum going and always use up stuff and hit pan on stuff, you know? If you keep buying stuff, you will keep having products to hit pan on. So it will be an ongoing project until we don't want to do it anymore. So let me show you guys the 2 pans that I have for this update. I have my Dolly 7 selfie powder right here, and I have pan, obviously, because yeah, obviously. So it is a good sized pan actually, and there's quite a dip. I think it is evened out, so kind of evenly, so that makes it pretty exciting, and the pan is expanding every single time I use it. I have used it for a few days now with the pan, and it has only gotten bigger, so that is pretty exciting. And I'm going to change it up for another powder that I will show you guys in a minute. I'm still going to keep on working on it, but for the sake of this project, it is going to be rolled out. The other pan comes from my highlighter palette from Mega Revolution. It is the Ultra Pro Glow palette, and it is so loved. It is so dirty and scratches everywhere. And the shade that I was working on was shade number 4, this one right here. And as you can see, there's a good size of pan. I did scrape out a little bit, but after I used up a little bit, I have used it since, and yeah, I hate pan. So that is pretty exciting. I am going to roll this out only because this color is way too dark for my skin tone right now. Hopefully I can get some good tan in the summer and I can use it there. I have used it once yesterday, I think, where I used it as an eyeshadow just to see how pigmented and bronzy it is, and it is quite dark. So yes, I am going to roll this out of the project and roll something else in first place. I have been loving using this palette, and I have hit 4 pans in this project, I think. So that's pretty exciting, and it looks so loved, and yeah, I'm actually quite excited to go back to this when times come around, and yes, maybe I could mix it in with other highlighters, but right now I just want to work on something else in my collection. Let's take the 2 items that I haven't hit pan on yet. The first one is from my blush stripe Paulina palette, and I am working on Siege, which is one of the darker green fronts I have in my whole collection project pan. I don't want to spoil anything. I don't think there's that much progress, but you know what I mean if you do project pans. But yes, I have some wear on it, but I haven't used it that much because I have really been focusing on some purples because of my fan shadows, so it hasn't gotten that much love. So I don't know if I regret putting in a darker green, but yeah, I really like this shadow, so I don't really mind. Hopefully I can wear some more green in the upcoming months. Let's see if I can find a balance between the pink purple looks and the more greeny looks. Then we have the Essence Mosaic Blush in number 10, Miss Floral Coral. This is where I am now, so you can definitely see some of the print is wearing off right here in the center, and the darker color of the pan is really disappearing in this small part right here. I think that is pretty exciting, and I love wearing this for the springtime. It has been so amazing to wear, so no regrets at putting this in, but it will take a while before I hit pan on this, but it is a blush. And if you pan a blush, you know how long it takes to hit pan. Then we are here for the two products that I'm adding in. And for the powder, I am adding in this face powder. It is also a Dove 7 product. It is the Flawless Faced Pressed version. This red here, I am working on the loose one for my whole collection project pan. But I thought because that is nearly done, I can roll this one in. I don't think it is as color correcting as the loose powder version, but it has some dots and some wear. I wouldn't say it has a dip, but you can definitely see some wear in the product. Down here I haven't worn it much, but up here you can see the it's kind of gritty. I don't know if that is a bad thing, but it has always looked like that, even when it was kind of brand new. I suppose the dots in the powder is supposed to be color correcting, but they are so small, so I don't think they do anything. But yes, it has a nice mirror as well, and let's see how fast I can hit pan on this. I'm going to use this for all over my face. The selfie powder I strictly used under my eyes. I have it on today under my eyes as well. It is really, really brightening, which is amazing for pale-skinned girls, because not a lot of powders do that without it looking white. This is mainly going to be used on my face, I think, so I'm excited to see how well it works with the foundation that I'm panning, because I haven't tested that out. Maybe I should, but I haven't. The last thing that I want to show you guys is my Dove 7 Glow Motion Pink It Up Shimmer Highlighter Eyeshadow. It's a highlighter. So this is the product right here, and yes, it is a pinkish highlighter. It's not that dark on the skin, so I think it is going to work well with the purple and the pink looks that I'm panning right now. I'm just really, really excited for this to be in this project and get some use out of it, because I've only used it a few times since I got it, which is bad, but now I can really get some use out of it and try to pan on it. So let's see how well I'm going to do that. In this highlighter there is 8.5 grams of product, which is a lot, and I don't think, if I remember correctly, you don't need much on your face for this highlighter. In this powder, the Flawless Face one, that is 8 grams. So there's a half a gram more highlighter than powder. That is quite amazing, actually. Let's see how much there is in the blush, just because I'm curious. That is 4.5 grams. It's a half a size of this highlighter, so wow. Not a highlighter, I guess. He wants to say hi. He's just waiting for me to lift him up. He looks happy. He is happy, right? That is everything for this update. I did consider putting more eyeshadows in, but I think I'm working on enough right now. But yeah, I did consider putting in some pinks and purple. I don't know why, but I did. I hope you guys enjoyed this series at least, and you will check out the other ladies down below. I have their channels and stuff like that linked, so you can check them out. And my playlist, of course, for this project is going to be in the description box as well. I hope you guys enjoyed, and until my next video, please take care of yourself. Bye!